Welcome to November, guys. Today, I'm going to do a plan with me session out loud with you. Why would I do such a thing? Well, it's not because I want this to be the Karen show. I actually don't want this to be the Karen show. But what I want to show you is how I externalize structure. Because if you have an ADHD brain like me, or if you have a very fast brain, if you're easily distracted, then the best thing you can do for yourself to create structure and boundaries is to externalize as much as you possibly can about what it is you want to do, what you're going after, your goals, your organizational systems, your planning systems, because keeping them up here is a really crappy place for any of us to keep things. So with that said, today we are going to plan November. What I will say is that before I plan a month, I will actually review the previous month. So I did a plan with me in October. I didn't do it in Notion. I did it in the Panda Planner because I was doing a review of it. So if you want to see my October plans, they're up here somewhere. I'll link it. But for November, what I want to do is go back to my October goals and see how I did, make any adjustments as necessary. But I want to show you more about the structure than what actually is going on in my life. So with that said, let's look at the template that I use. I know you're going to ask me if I have this template. And to be quite honest, I do have a Notion template for sale. Doesn't really include all of this stuff. So if you are interested in me kind of recreating this, let me know and I will be happy to share it with you. So I have set up a new page in Notion. If you don't use Notion, this is not about the software, it's about the structure. So the way I like to set up a month is to set up a new sheet which has all of these various different prompts that help me organize my thoughts. So if, let's pretend this was October and I was just settling the month and reviewing it in order to move into November. I would do business reflections. I would do a business revenue reflection where I take in all of my various different revenue sources and plug them in here. So I get like an overall snapshot of, you know, what did my business bring in? And then I do intuitive hits. And this month is going to be really interesting. In my last video, I shared that I've been seeing the symbols 1111 everywhere. And apparently that means that there's some guardian angels out there telling me I'm on the right path. And as I mentioned in that previous video, I have no idea which path that guardian angel is talking about, but I have the assumption it's about work and spirituality and sort of the intersection of those two things. And when I'm talking about spirituality, I'm talking about intuitive development and just learning to calm the F down. And then I also go through a process of recording my wins. So I've got a whole database here. And the reason I record my wins is that if you, like me, you have a very fast brain, you have a tendency to glaze right, or is it gloss? Glaze or gloss, whatever. You have a tendency to gloss glaze right over all of your accomplishments. And then the narrative you have going on in your head is that I never finish things, I don't do things right, nah. But in reality, you do, you just don't slow down fast enough to see that you've accomplished something, take that in, let it marinate in your short-term memory, which will then let it connect into your long-term memory, which will then connect to your identity. These are really important steps. This is neuroscience, not woo-woo. So marinate on your wins. However you do it, I do mine in Notion. And then I do some personal reflections and some personal spending. I just like to manage my spending. I'm not one to do a budget because that would be something that I would rail against. But I know generally how much I spend in a month. And then at the end of the month, when I do my reflection, I can connect to that and really see where I need to make adjustments. That's what works for me. It's a little bit more fluid as opposed to you can have this much money for groceries in a month. That would drive me banana pants. So once I've got all of my reflections done, I then go into my goals, projects, and tasks for this month. So if I look back at my goals for October, I have visit an RV show, did that, and decided I no longer want to have an RV. Remember a couple of months ago when I was saying I was obsessed with RVs? That obsession went from here to here, and now it's back down to here. I went to the RV show. I took a look at the RVs. They were all really cute, but I realized that A, it would take up too much effort, and I don't want more complications in my life. B, I would have to like be at campsites close to people who snore, and that's just not going to happen for this girl. And C, I really like the comforts of home. So scratch the RVs. It was a great sort of thought experiment, but I did not spend any money on it. I watched a lot of videos. That is it. That obsession has gone to the side and we move on with life. The other goal that I had was to be gluten-free at home. I would say check, I got that done. and complete D2A content. That's a distraction action. I completed the content. I completed the program. It went really, really well. I have so much appreciation and gratitude to my beta group. So if you're listening to this from my beta group, thank you guys. You are just awesome. The other goals that I had for October, reaching 2,500 subscribers on YouTube, I met that goal. So yay me. And then finished reading the book on intuition, which was actually due in September. No, I still haven't done that, and it's totally okay. Complete my program with authenticity. Yes, I did that. When I say authenticity, that means to me doing it in a way that is aligned with my energy and how I want to show up in the world, and I believe that I did do that. So I have reviewed my goals. Now at this point, I would now set goals for November. And I would set them here in this video, but I really like to marinate on what I just ran through and think about what's most important to me this month. Like, what is my one thing for this month? And I do know what my one thing is, so I will share that with you. So that's my goal review. And that really helps me prepare for the month ahead. Because once I know what my goals are, then I can go into my active projects and decide which one am I focusing on. So what am I talking about here? Let's come up into my template. What is my one thing for the month of November? And that is to complete requirements for advanced program. I have to tell you, I've got like these long nails on because I don't pick my cuticles as much when I have nails on, but it makes typing an interesting thing. And then I always go into the month with like three feels. So what are my feels coming into November? I'm kind of stoked. I feel a little vulnerable doing this right now. I don't know why. And happy. I'm also very grateful. I'm only usually doing three, but today I get four. I'm grateful for you guys. And then success, challenges, lessons learned, and gratitude is something that I will do at the end of November. So I will share that with you when we get into planning December. And then what I'll do, and I won't bore you to go through all this with me, but I will do my YouTube followers, Instagram followers, podcast audience. Are you guys listening to my podcast? It's the ADHD-Friendly Show. I'll also link it below. Please follow my podcast, please. And my email list, you should also get on that because that's where you're going to get all of my videos and all of my podcasts. And then I'll also review my energy, what I loved and hated doing over the month. And this is critical because I'm always trying to stay intentional about the things I'm doing in my business. And listen, y'all, if you're an ADHDer with a business, or maybe you have like a full-time job and a side hustle, or maybe you have a full-time job and 16 side hustles, and I bet you have that, because we have this problem with wanting to do all of the things. And the problem with wanting to do all of the things is that we can't, because we are limited by our humanness and the fact that there's only 24 hours in a day. But that generally doesn't stop us from saying yes to all the things. I've talked about this before, but if you're new to my channel, then hear this. If you want to avoid burnout, it starts with you stopping overcommitment. The motto around here is doing less, but creating more space to not feel overwhelmed all the freaking time. Coming back to my Notion template, a lot of this I will leave until the end of the month, but I also like to pick something that I'm manifesting. And that is basically my November setup. So my goals for this month, as I mentioned, are going to be around my coaching program, making sure I have all my recordings submitted. I have like a year-end project I need to submit and a few other things. So what I'll do is spend some time breaking down exactly what needs to be done and on what dates. And then I will add those to my weekly calendar so that every week I know that at the top of the week, I have a one thing that I need to do that week. And that will be the tasks associated with completing my advanced course. And that is generally how I set up my month and my previous month. One other thing I'll show you is when I am planning my months, I also like to come back to my values, needs, strengths, and bucket list database. And this is just how I have put them into my daily planner so that I remember them. But you can like make vision boards, you can put in your journal, you can do whatever you want with it. So the first thing I review are my core values, like what is most important to me. And for me, that's financial stability, peace, freedom, meaningful work, and flow. So As I'm making my goals for November, I'm going to keep these things in mind and ask myself, does this goal align to my financial stability? Does it align to my freedom? Does it align to my meaningful work? And does it flow? Those are the things that I'll ask myself. And then I'll also remind myself of my character strengths. I like to look at this as I'm setting up my month because that is my way of externalizing intention. We all want to be a little bit more intentional, but we often forget what we're trying to be intentional about. And then I do a reflection on my needs. So for me, that's going to be making sure that I'm making enough time for working out and speaking to my friends and family and staying connected, planning the courses that I want to do in 2023, because I will always be a lifelong student. So that is how I stay aligned and intentional to my personal goals rather than the world around me. So if you want to be internally directed, if you want to be as true a reflection of who you are as possible, make sure that you are aware of your goals, your character strengths, your needs, and make sure you're always planning in alignment to those things. I know it sounds a little woo-woo, but it is actually steeped in science and it is actually a great practice. So on that note, guys, thank you for listening. I will see you in the next video.